Hi everyone, here is some information on what items come in your flight feeder kit. I'll be telling you about what some of the pieces do and how to connect it together. Unfortunately, every setup is unique, so we are unable to provide specific instructions on where to place the flight feeder or antenna. If you need ideas for mounting or running the cable outside, please see the flight feeder instructions on our website or the optional section of the PiAware setup. Let's start with the main part, the flight feeder. Inside are several circuit boards that take the signal received by the antenna, translate the signal into a digital stream, and then send the data to FlightAware. There are two main types of messages received by the setup, MODES and ADS-B signals. ADS-B messages include most of the information needed to track an aircraft, like the location, tail number, direction, and speed. MODES messages, on the other hand, don't include location. So if your station sends a message to FlightAware about a particular aircraft, FlightAware will look for the other stations nearby that also sent a message about the aircraft. And if four or more stations send a message to FlightAware, the location of that aircraft can be pinpointed. This is called multilateration, more commonly referred to as MLAT. If FlightAware is able to determine the aircraft's location using MLAT, a message will be sent back to the flight feeder and you will be able to view the aircraft on SkyView, which is a web portal to view a map showing the current aircraft the flight feeder is receiving messages from. To view SkyView, navigate to the flight feeder's IP address in a browser, or a link can be found on the stats page. Communication happens fast, but if an aircraft is being tracked via MLAT, it may take up to a minute to display on SkyView. When setting up the flight feeder, you will need to locate an area near power and a network port. Lastly, plan for your setup to be near where the antenna cable will run outside when the antenna is mounted outdoors. If you plan to use a LAN connection, connect the network cable to the flight feeder and your router. If you plan to use Wi-Fi, start by connecting the black antenna to the port labeled NET in black. If this is connected to the incorrect plug, the flight feeder could be damaged and require replacement. The larger connector on the antenna is called an N-type connector, and this is what you will screw into the antenna like so. Next up, connect the SMA connector into the flight feeder to the port labeled in white, ADS-B. Do not use a filter in this setup because it will cause problems with the communications between the antenna and the flight feeder's GPS chips. Lastly, connect the flight feeder to power. If the power adapter comes with the incorrect connector, swap it out by pressing the button in the middle and removing it. Then slide the correct connector on until you hear a click. Once everything is connected, set the antenna upright in a window so it has a clear view of the sky to receive a signal from the GPS satellites and some ADS-B messages. After it is powered up the device status. Once the device has started to receive information, the radio light will turn green when a signal is received from an aircraft. MLAT will turn yellow once the device has received a GPS location, and green when there is synchronization between nearby sites. This will only happen if there are nearby sites. GPS will turn yellow once it has a lock on a satellite and is synchronizing, then turn green once the device is synchronized and has a lock on the location. If your GPS status stays as yellow or red after an hour, please contact FlightAware at adsbsupport@flightaware.com. The network will turn green once the flight feeder is connected to the local network. Gateway will turn green when the flight feeder is connected to the internet. FlightAware will turn green when the flight feeder has sent a message to FlightAware and received one back. Within 15 minutes, the LED on the side indicating the GPS should blink only green. If this does not happen or another color is displaying, like yellow or red, please email ADS-B support. Wait approximately 5 minutes and check your ADS-B stats page, which will be a link at the top of the FlightAware webpage when you are logged in called My ADS-B. The stats page won't be available until your site has received a signal and sent the data to FlightAware, which could take a few minutes or longer depending on your location. To check this sooner, look up the IP address in your router's admin page and type that into a browser to see status information. Good luck on your setup. Feel free to email any questions to adsbsupport@flightaware.com. Optionally, if you plan to set up Wi-Fi, go to Network, Built-in Wireless Connection, select Scan for Wireless Network, select your network, confirm, then enter your password. After starting this, it may take a while for it to connect to your network. Please leave it for about 5 minutes. If that doesn't function, please email us at adsbsupport@flightaware.com.